Okay, today I will tell you important cases which are commonly encountered in station 5. Please keep in mind that common is always common. Okay, the candidates who are scared that we don't know what will come in the station 5 and unimportant and unusual and unseen cases are coming. This is, I agree with this. But this is, I think, only 10%. 90% the common topics, they will come. The common topics, the common cases which we are hearing, which we are discussing, which we are reading, which we are seeing on daily basis, these will come. The only thing is when if candidates, they cannot appreciate, they cannot diagnose the common case, then they mislead other candidates that this is very difficult and such case came and such case came. But things are revealed once you get your feedback, and then you know that the case was common but you could not diagnose. Okay, so always pay more attention to the common cases and practice more for the common cases, because there are 90% chances that you will get out of these stations or out of these cases, and rest is your luck and your destiny. That if you unluckily if you got out of that 10%, do not ignore those 10% cases as well, but do not exert as much your attention and hard work on the uncommon cases as compared to common cases. Exert your 90% of attention and practice and time to the common cases. Okay, so that if commons are always common, they are coming, and if it comes, then you don't have any difficulty and you can diagnose immediately. So please, you can write down, it's rheumatology, it's ankylosing spondylitis, rheumatoid arthritis, psoriasis, gout, Paget's, an examination of knee and shoulder, chest pain, palpitation. In endocrinology, Cushing's, acromegaly, thyroid, Addison, hypopituitarism. Out of this acromegaly and thyroid, oh my god, I can't tell you how much this is common and how much commonly this is coming. Every third candidate is getting acromegaly or thyroid. And in the eye, you can get blurring of vision, peripheral loss of vision, central loss of vision, color vision problem. Or either you can broadly divide it as either transient acute loss of vision and chronic loss of vision and transient visual disturbance. So you can categorize it like this. And in gastroenterology, hematemesis, melena, diarrhea, jaundice, HHT, hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia, very common. Tremor, ptosis, low limb swelling in the form of DVT or edema, obstructive sleep apnea, lymphadenopathy, Raynaud's phenomena, very common, monoarthritis or polyarthritis, mouth ulcers, neck lump, neurofibromatosis and tuberous sclerosis, pemphigus, I mean rash can come, and most commonly from the rash. There are some rash which are very common, but pemphigus also they are giving. Vitiligo, psoriasis if it comes with the rash, and erythroderma, and SLE, tall stature, systemic sclerosis, dermatomyositis, vitiligo, and diabetes related skin diseases. And in the eyes, I have told you acute and chronic and transient visual disturbance. And in that which comes topics also, I told you blurring of vision, peripheral loss of vision, central vision loss, color vision loss, optic atrophy, retinitis pigmentosa, choroidoretinitis, and most commonly diabetic and hypertensive retinopathies. Okay. And fever in the returning traveler. So these are the common out of common cases, and you should practice for these cases at least many times. you should practice for the rest cases also. Do not leave the rest cases. The 60 cases which are described in the rider meet, practice for all. Okay? But out of those, I told you the most important which are coming. So, if anything else I remembered, I recalled, I will add on. Okay? Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.